there's something about early morning that is just nauseating. I haven't been around for quite some time. And honestly, like, I don't know what has happened, but I've just been reevaluating things and trying to figure out what's important to me, what's not important to me. Typical, like, crisis bullshit that seems to happen to me every couple years. So this is nothing new. I'm sure I've made this video 3 or 4 times in the past. Probably why I'm making it now, because when I started doing YouTube videos, I was just a young idealist that thought that my opinion held more weight than other people's for whatever reason. I look back at that with a lot of shame. But I always felt as if I was smarter than the average person. Which turned out to be bullshit, by the way. But back then, I had a lot of confidence that I've since lost in myself. I've just reached a point in my life where I don't know what to do. At all. When I focus on my photography, which is what I'm doing now. Here's a little clip show of my 365 project that I'm doing. This footage comes from way back in the winter when I had an idea for a video that I never made. And this footage has just been sitting on my computer ever since. Figured, why not use it? Here you go.
Part of this is how fucking cold you get. Oh man, can't feel my hands.
Focus on this stuff, I hear constantly, like, why aren't you doing videos? You're so good at it. Last year, which was a really down year for my photography, I had tons of people telling me, why aren't you focusing on your photography? You're so good at it. When I don't write for a long time, I hear the same type of thing. When I don't do music for a while, same thing. The truth, honestly, is that I'm not really good at any of it, except maybe photography. I might be decent at photography. But even then, I don't hold a candle to people I admire. I'm no fucking Ansel Adams, you know what I'm saying? And as I've gotten older, I've started to learn that about myself. I showed a lot of promise when I was a kid. I had a lot of ambition about it because there was a spark there that has since kind of tapered off a little bit, drifted into the trees. And sometimes it catches, you know, in certain ways. I'll do something that I'm really proud of, but I'm only proud of it for a while. When time sets in and I have the grace of introspection, I never like anything I do, ever. To this day, of the thousands upon thousands of things I've made, I can count on one hand the amount of things I've made that I'm like, it's pretty damn good. But that's as far as it ever gets, just pretty damn good. And I suppose that my own self-consciousness, as the years have carried on and the weight of accepting mediocrity has started to weigh on my shoulders like a giant fucking rock or some secret that I don't want to keep, it's become harder and harder for me to invest my energies. And instead, I invest them in places where they probably don't belong. I need projects to keep me going. That's why this photo a day for a year thing is always good for me, because it gives me a reason to do it. I'm working on a book right now. It gives me a reason to write. I'm working on an album. Gives me a reason to make music. I can't just do it for the sake of doing it anymore, and that's something that weighs on me, again, like a rock, or a secret I don't want to keep. Drifting off track, let's get back on. My problem with YouTube as a medium, there's two of them. I guess there's three. The first one, the most shallow reason of all, is that I don't have an audience here anymore. You look at my view counts. They're embarrassing. A few years ago, I took a few years off. I worked. Like, I did the traditional thing. I didn't have time to make videos. And then even when I had the time to do it, I didn't want to, because part of my job at the time was to do videos and marketing and stuff, and I just didn't want to touch my camera. Which, by the way, a lot of people say, if you can turn your passion into a job, you never work a day in your life. It's bullshit. And it'll make you lose the love for the art itself, or your craft, whatever it is. Because if you have to do it, you don't want to do it at all when you don't have to. It's just another job, it's a gig. But in doing that, people forgot about me. Which I understand. I think back at some of the YouTubers that I used to watch, and I can see their faces, but I can't for the life of me remember their channel names. Why would I think that I was any different than that? Especially when my content was, at best, sporadic. I did too many things. You know, I had music videos here, rants here, video journals here, reels here. Here's some music videos I did for other people. Here's some projects I did here. There was no continuity with any of it, ever. When I built my audience, I had a little bit. I just talked to a camera, and people seemed to enjoy that for whatever reason. A few people. I mean, I never reached any kind of, like, real status. Oh my god, am I not even filming right now? Okay. Whew. I never reached the level of acclaim that I thought I would. Like, I really thought I had something for a little bit. Wish these birds would shut the fuck up. And you know, as the landscape of YouTube changed, and this is where my second problem is, over time I felt like the old dude. Like, I don't understand this platform anymore, and I'm sure it's because it's been infiltrated by young people that I don't understand to begin with. Which is fine, I accept that. It's what happens, you know, in any art form. You start out as the young, hip, cool person. I use that term very loosely. I've never been cool or hip, but I mean, just for the sake of conversation, I at least understood why things were cool and hip. And eventually, you become old and you don't understand the youth and why people enjoy the things they do. And out of all the websites and apps that exist, I think YouTube is the most responsible for making stupid people famous. It started when I was younger on television. People really liked stupid people. And it's just gotten to the point where you have to be dumb to achieve stardom. Like, we are so anti-intellectual in America, and not just America, like, as the world kind of condenses in on itself while everybody is consuming the same kind of content, it's a global thing now, where if you eke out intelligence and you try to be smart, not saying I am smart, but I try to make myself knowledgeable and learn things, and that is looked upon as, like, that's fucking boring, dude. You're pretentious as fuck because you're using words that have more than three syllables. You don't have a catchphrase. And that leads me to my third issue with YouTube, which is I'm just not really interested anymore. I'm more interested in exploring art at my own pace without worrying about algorithms and thumbnails and just the formulas that go into to being a YouTuber, which I never wanted to be to begin with. I viewed YouTube as a platform that would, I'd start here and it would take me to where I want to go. Kind of like a less funny Bo Burnham or something, who's now doing amazing, terrific things. Never really happened for me. It's kind of like a snake eating its own tail, in a way. And that's why I've decided to make this video, because I don't like leaving what few of you are left, whom I appreciate dearly. I don't want to leave you in the dark and make you feel like I'm going through this, like, really dark time, which is what usually happens. when I drift away from YouTube for a long time. I mean, I'm not saying I'm not either. It's kind of, it's just by the day. I have good days and I have bad days. Some days I wake up and I get shit done and I feel accomplished, I feel good. And other days I'm just like, why am I, is anything good ever gonna fucking happen in my life ever? Ever? Is anything good gonna happen? Which is, of course, fucking, like, a pity party. Good things happen to me all the time. I have people in my life that genuinely love me. I'm not lonely at all. In fact, I would argue the opposite. There's too much. Too many people are interested in what I'm doing and talking to me a lot of the time. Which is different. I have more friends now than I ever have in my life. And I honestly don't know what to do with them all. And I don't know why they like me, either. I struggle with that as well. Just, I've reached my 30s. Which is where usually things begin to become concrete. You start to realize things about yourself, like, this works for me, this doesn't. You start to learn what you're about, like, that's what your 20s are supposed to be. I think that never happened for me either. Every year I seem to get less confident about who I am and what I like. When I think about myself and who I am, I largely feel like I'm a character. Every person sees this character in a different way, and they pick and pull what they like about that character, but I don't think many people really know who I am. And it's not because I'm some complex, deep person, it's just because I don't know who I am. At all. No fucking idea anymore. There are days where I wake up and I never want to touch a camera again. It happens. I never want to pick up a pencil and write anything. I look at people with other skill sets, like electricians and plumbers and people that paint cars or put sliding glass doors on houses. I look at them with envy a lot of the time because those are skill sets that I wish I possessed that I just don't. And I'd like to be more well-rounded as an individual, as a human being. I'd like to have more skill sets than I have. The only thing I'm decent at, and I'm not convinced I'm good at it at all, is this kind of shit. Like, I wish I was an athlete, like a world star athlete, because of course the fucking air conditioner is going to come on. Well, there's going to be a buzz for the last minute or so of this video. Ignore it, please. Sorry. But with certain things, like being an athlete or working on cars, there's no gray area to whether or not you are talented at it. You can hate LeBron James, but you can't deny that the dude knows how to play basketball really, really fucking well. If you're good at painting cars or building motorcycles or cooking food, you can hate the person, but you have to acknowledge their skill set. That is not the case when it comes to art. For every one person that thinks you're great at it, there's five people that think you suck and don't get it at all. And in that way, art feels like the most fruitless of all endeavors because you're never, ever going to be satisfied. Ever. And the second you do become satisfied as an artist, your art begins to suffer because you're no longer trying to attain something greater. So I feel like I'm caught in this paradox because the same thing that keeps me motivated to keep trying is the same thing that I feel like has held me back my entire life. This self-conscious part of my brain that, and it's so surface level, shallow, but this constant need to be acknowledged and respected as somebody that is talented. Like, you're good at what you do. And I'm sure it stems from an entire childhood of friends and peers and family and teachers telling me that, encouraging me. You show a lot of fucking promise, kid. And I'm sure a lot of those people look at me now at 30 and they think, man, I really thought you were gonna do something and you never did. And now I don't even know what it is I'd wanna do. I don't know if I ever have. I realize that the title of this video is What to Do When You Lose an Audience, which is a total farce because the truth is, I don't know. I don't know what to do. I don't want to talk to a camera. I feel like I'm better at telling stories when I'm writing it down. I have no real desire to be a YouTuber at all. But at this point, I wouldn't even be picky about it. I just want to be successful. And I'm either doing something wrong. Like, there's two options here. I'm either doing something wrong, and I actually am talented. I actually am good at what I do. And I'm just not figuring out how to apply it in a way that will bring me success. Or, and this is terrifying to me, I'm just fucking average. And if I'm average, what is there left to say?